96.
Darling, how are you?
Barbara.
Do you remember Tom Ford? If I were you, I'd sort of lose his case file.
Who is this Brad Collins, anyway?
Well, if I'm right, it's a cover name for Bill Maddox.
Isn't this the guy who looted some union pension fund and skipped to Central America?
Guess who his chief accountant was?
Tom Ford.
Ford checked into an exclusive clinic and health spa, which is run by Dr. Paul Redmond.
So Collins is really Maddox, and now he's going to Redmond for a complete overhaul.
Bosley, Chris, I've already made an appointment for you at Redmond's office. 10 o'clock day after tomorrow.
Come on, Charlie. Who's going to believe that Chris needs the services of Dr. Redmond?
Oh, no, wait. Hold on. No way.
Well, not long after he talked to me this morning, Tom Ford died.
So he did.
Paul, they murdered him.
They? Who are they?
Bradford Collins.
I think I saw his name on the reservation list at the spa. Is he the murderer?
But I don't see how a blepharoplasty or a rhinoplasty could possibly require more difficult post-op care. Or a retinectomy, for that matter.
It's rhinoplasty. But anyone who cares enough to look up those jawbreakers could be exactly what we're looking for. Tiffany, this is Julie Evers.
Look at you. That face. It's easy for you.
What do you say? I just sit here. You want to talk? We'll talk. If you don't, I'll just sit here.
Doctor, look at these cheeks. Will you look at these cheeks? I mean, they used to be cute. Do you know what I mean? Now I wake up in the morning to a potential mudslide.
When do I see the Wonder Doctor?
Mm-mm. First, my money for taking care of Tom Ford.
Thank you.
Mr. Maddox, isn't it? Good. That makes things easier.
I knew you were going to like that. That's three times your customary fee. Ford said that you were good at altering fingerprints. So am I. I figure that's about 200 pounds. I'd hate to see anything happen to your hand, Doctor.
I can't understand a word you are saying.
Ugh. 10 miles of biking and 100 miles of chewing.
100 miles of chewing?
With the pterygoid and mylohyoid.
The what?
Double chin, remember? Ah.
Right.
Oz. Honey, you really don't look too good.
Oh, no kidding. Well, you wouldn't either, with all of this going for you, and snooping around this place until all hours of the night.
Did you get a look at Bradford Collins?
No, they stood out there in the patio, and it's too well hidden.
Tiffany, do you think you could get in there?
Mm-mm, room's restricted. But the head nurse told me that surgery is scheduled for tomorrow. Now, if we can...
I mean, do you think it's easy keeping track of the servants, managing the menus?
Hello, Mrs. Bosley.
Oh, hello, Doctor. The nurse here tells me that my husband is cooperating with you a little bit more than he cooperates with me.
John's doing very well, as a matter of fact.
Well, that's something. But when your husband lets himself get in this... You'll have to excuse me. I have an appointment with my hairdresser.
I'll see you to your car, Mrs. Bosley.
Bye-bye, precious.
Listen to me, Julie. I knew a girl once. She was happy, outgoing. She was a beautiful girl. Until one night on the way to a school dance, her face went through a windshield. It was 2 years of plastic surgery and therapy before she got her face back. And you know who she had to thank for it? A doctor. One very much like Dr. Redmond.
Hello, Julie. Ready for the unveiling?
Yes, sir. I guess so, if Tiffany can stay with me.
I'll stay with you.
You were very good in there, Miss Wells. That bandaging was perfection.
Thank you. I confess I hit the books last night.
Oh, no, the way you handle a patient doesn't come from books. It comes from here and here. But by the way, that was a very touching story you came up with. And I will use it sometime, if you don't mind.
That wasn't a story. I was talking about my cousin.
I can't do this to you, Mrs. Redmond. I just lied to you.
I'm not with any bank or financial agency. I'm with Charles Townsend and Associates. Look, I don't blame you if you throw me out. But I'm here because your husband is, or is about to be involved in some very deep trouble.
I've known that Paul's been seeing someone else for over a year.
Do you know who she is?
Here.
Hello, Mr. Bosley, and how are we this evening?
Hold it. You call this dinner?
That's what it says here.
Yeah, well, it's not funny, Tiffany. I hope whoever the guy is down the hall, he's not getting any better. Well, if it isn't the little woman.
Now, Bosley, I was just playing my part. You know what? Seriously, you really are looking better.
So is our case. Barbara Brown, alias Betty Rogers, alias Beth Richardson. She was a homecoming queen turned explosive expert for the underground.
Okay, Kelly and I'll have Charlie check it out.
Okay, I'll meet you back at the office as soon as I get off work.
Well, just what am I supposed to do?
Eat your peas.
I'm sure I've seen this face before. But the name's wrong. Maddox. Maddox.
Have you seen Elena? She knew we had a surgery this morning.
No, I haven't seen her.
Well, check in the office, will you, please?
Surely.
Elena.
She's dead. My guess is because she recognized this. It is Bill Maddox, isn't it?
Very astute. You have very competent help here. I think this young lady could provide you with any assistance you need during surgery.
Barbara.
If I were to bleed the lines, some of the ether and oxygen mixture would get into the air. That would be okay, wouldn't it?
I think it would definitely be okay.
Unless someone were to fire a gun in the operating room.
In which case, we'd all go up with a real boom.
Yep.
Inhalation anesthesia, please.
Thank you, doctor.
What's the holdup?
Could be the first operation where the patient survives and the doctor and the nurse don't.
Emergency. Have to see the doctor.
Nobody sees the doc. He's busy.
Freeze. Don't move a muscle. Tie him up, Chris.
So sorry. But you can't fire that gun.
What are you talking about?
You're an explosives expert. Take a good whiff.
Ether and oxygen.
One powder spark, and this place is going up like a Roman candle.
If you don't want to see this face destroyed, just turn off those tanks.
What's happening here?
Why, Bill Maddox, as I live and breathe.
Oh, don't frown, you'll get wrinkles. I can't believe it. Believe it, Julie. You're beautiful.
You don't know what she did for me.
She did a lot. For all of us.